Kabuliwala, a very popular story by Rabindranath Tagore, which explores the affectionate bond of friendship crossing the borders of caste, creed, language, religion, race or age. In this presentation, I'm Dr. Madhavi Mohuril, Assistant Professor in English, Rajkumar Keval Ramani Kanya Mahavidyalaya Nagpur, is introducing the story by Rabindranath Tagore. Rabindranath Tagore was a versatile personality who dominated the world of literature. Besides being a first-rate writer, he was a musician, a painter, an educationist, and a philosopher. His musical compositions are known and favored by the people as Ravindra Sangeet. He was a great administrator and a staunch patriot too. Tagore is chiefly known as a composer of Indian national anthem. In 1901, Tagore founded an experimental school in rural West Bengal named Shanti Niketan, where he sought to blend the best in Indian and Western traditions. In 1913, he became the non-European to receive the Nobel Prize for Literature for the wonderful religious devotional compositions Gitanjali. In 1925, he was awarded knighthood by King George V, but he renounced the same in protest for Jallianwala Bagh mass killing. He was a great patriot. In West Bengal, he established Vishwa Bharati University, which proves his qualities as an educationist. Kabuliwala is a very simple and sensitive story by Tagore. The chief characters are Minnie, a girl of 5 years, Kabuliwala, a middle-aged man from Afghanistan, Minnie's father, who is a writer, and Minnie's mother. The story revolves around these four characters. The story begins with the introduction of Minnie, who is very talkative by nature. She is very favorite to her father. Chatty girl Minnie shares so many stories to her busy father. One day, she calls Kabuliwala, a middle-aged fruit seller who is from Kabul. Tagore paints out gradual development of friendship between Minnie and Kabuliwala. Kabuliwala becomes a silent listener to Minnie. These are some of the glimpses from the story. Minnie's father expresses Minnie's talkative nature as, "Before I could explain to her the difference between one language and another in this world, she had embarked on the full tide of another subject. What do you think, father? Pola says there is an elephant in the clouds blowing water out of his trunk, and that is why it rains." One day, she calls Kabuliwala. At that very moment, the Kabuliwala turned and looked up at the child. When she saw this, she was overcome by terror and, running to her mother's protection, disappeared. She had a blind belief that inside the bag which the big man carried, there were perhaps 2 or 3 other children like herself. Tagore's skill as a storyteller can be seen with this description of Minnie and Kabuliwala's amicable bonding. When his father observes Minnie seated on the bench near the door, laughing and talking with the great Kabuliwala at her feet. In all her life, it appeared, my small daughter had never found so patient a listener, save her father. And already the corner of the little study was stuffed with almonds and raisins. The gift a visitor. "Why did you give this to her?" I said, and taking out an 8-anna price, I handed it to him. The man accepted the money without demur and put it into his pocket. The story progresses with the other two characters. Minnie's father, a writer, a very mature personality. He observes a good bonding between Minnie and Kabuliwala. He is sensitive and sensible enough to understand Kabuliwala from different facets. But Minnie's mother is very timid. She does not like this and suspects Kabuliwala as a kidnapper. It becomes clear with this description. Mini's mother would intervene and implore me to be aware of that man. Mini's mother is unfortunately very timid. Whenever she hears a noise in the street or sees people coming towards the house, she always jumps to the conclusion that they are either thieves or drunkards or snakes or tigers or malaria or cockroaches or caterpillars. Even after all these years of experience, she is not able to overcome her terror. So, she was full of doubts about the Kabuliwala and used to beg me to keep a watchful eye on him. Kabuliwala's preparations to go back to his family can be seen when, once a year in the middle of January, Rehman, the Kabuliwala, used to return to his own country, and the time approached, he would be very busy going from house to house, recalling his debts. It is said that complications or problem is the soul of the story. Tagore has woven it in a very effective way when, one morning, it was nearly 8 o'clock. Suddenly, I heard an uproar in the street and looking out, saw Rehman being led away bound between two policemen and behind them a crowd of inquisitive boys. There were blood stains on his clothes and one of the policemen carried a knife. Inquired what it all meant. I gathered that a certain neighbor had owed a peddler something for Rampuri shawl but had denied buying it. That in the course of the quarrel, Rehman had struck him. As a result, on a charge of murderous assault, Rehman was sentenced to several years imprisonment. He was behind the bar. Time passed. Kabuliwala was forgotten. Even little-hearted Minnie forgot her old friend. New companions filled her life. Years passed. Minnie is grown up as a young girl fit to marry. Her father says, "It was once more autumn and we had made arrangement for our Minnie's marriage. It was to take place during the Puja holidays. With Durga returning to Kailash, the light of our home also would depart to her husband's house and leave her father's shadow." Surprisingly, on the day of Minnie's marriage, Kabuliwala releases from jail and comes to meet his friend Minnie. His wait to see little friend is presented by Tagore with great emotions. Minnie's father empathizes him as a father of a girl and allows him to see Minnie. He calls her and Minnie comes, beautifully dressed in the bride's costume. Young Minnie could not recognize her old friend. This very realistic but pathetic moment makes Kabuliwala nostalgic to his own daughter. He feels sad. It is said, when she had gone, Rehman sighed deeply and sat down to the floor. The idea had suddenly come to him that his daughter too must have grown up. Assuredly, he would not find her as she was when he left her. And besides, what might not have happened to her in these 8 years? At last, Minnie's father feels sad for Kabuliwala and suggests Kabuliwala, "Go back to your daughter, Rehman, in your own country and may the happiness of your meeting bring good fortune to my child." With these suggestions and advice to Kabuliwala, the story concludes. The story appeals to the heart as it brings out various facets of human emotions. It presents purity of emotion through the beautiful bond between Minnie and Kabuliwala. It shows apprehensiveness of Minnie's mother for the safety of her daughter. It depicts or it brings out empathy failed by Minnie's father for Kabuliwala as father. It shows anger of Kabuliwala results in murderous assault. It depicts Kabuliwala's nostalgia for his family and daughters. Finally, it brings out Kabuliwala's longing for his family, which is very touching. The story is the masterpiece of Rabindranath Tagore.